an early retirement. Shane, you're very welcome to the show. How are things?
Yeah, good morning. How are you?
Not too bad. It feels strange, I must say, saying that, former Limerick hurler. I can imagine it's been an extremely weird week for you emotionally over the last few days.
Yeah, and I think you're the first person to put it to me like that, so thanks for that. Yeah, it's been, listen, yesterday was quite mad, and it wasn't as bad as I expected in terms of how I thought it was going to feel, but because the previous 2 weeks were extremely difficult, and a lot of the emotional side of it was gotten out of the way by that stage, you know. It's been very difficult. I'm not going to lie, but you know, it's, what can you do? It's part of life, isn't it? And I'm being very fortunate to be part of the Limerick team for so long, and you know, I got to achieve what I wanted, and at the end of the day, that's the bottom line for me. Of course, I wanted to go on for a couple of years, but I nailed down what I always wanted to get, really.
So what has been the timeline of events here, Shane, from realising that you had to hang up the boots to telling all the interested parties that now was the time for you to walk away?
Yeah, so Wednesday 2 weeks ago, I went down to get a small procedure, a scope on my knee, just to remove some loose bodies. And to my mind, I was going to get them taken out, close up, and I thought I was going to be back running this week or the weekend or whatever, you know. But when he went in, there was more damage and more defect in the cartilage. And, it's in the same knee for the last couple of years. And the cartilage is just diseased, as he put it, basically. And, it's just never ending, really.
When did these issues first start, Shane?
I first got injured in the county final of October 2017 in the Pearshig. And I returned at half time of the Schlock Neil game in the All Ireland Club semi final in 2018. Albeit probably came back too early, but obviously that was a very important game. So I came on, even as I said, I probably shouldn't have fed. And from February 2018 to August 2019, I was having pain on and off. It didn't go or anything like that, you know. I was able to play away with it, and then in August of last year, after the All Ireland semi final versus Kilkenny, I was playing a club match, and literally I was doing nothing because I was marking Declan Hannan the same day, and I just remember saying, "I said, Jesus, I'm gone on my knee." He didn't move, or you didn't really, probably didn't move at all. He said, but he said, I didn't twist, I didn't do anything mad on it, like, you know. So I tried to run it off, and I could actually feel something moving in my knee. So I said, no, there's something not right. So then I got an MRI, and it showed up that, I had another osteochondral defect in my knee, is what it's called, you know. And so I got the procedure done last September. I spent 3 months on crutches, and since then, it's just been, it's been aggravating me and at me, and I've done everything, and so then, as I said, about maybe 6 or 8 weeks ago, I went down and got another MRI because I couldn't continue the way I was going. Mentally, it was getting the better of me, because I was too sore. I knew there was something wrong, and obviously with COVID, I was extremely lucky that Tiger Sullivan got me in quick and done another MRI on me, and he spotted a loose body in my knee, but he said that the procedure that I got done in September was perfect. So I was happy with that because I thought, scope is 2 weeks recovery time. So then I got the procedure 2 weeks ago, and that's when obviously we spotted the further damage.
Right. So even though this has been something that's been at you for quite some time, it really does feel like the severity of it has only come into view very recently.
Yeah, now, I spoke to one particular man in February, and he wanted to put me in a coffin and close me up, and I refused to do that because, I said, I have to look at every angle possible. So since then, I suppose it has been in the back of my mind that, things mightn't come right here, but I was going to give myself every opportunity, and I did. I rest easy knowing that I can't do anymore. I've done everything. I've done the rehab. I've done everything, but unfortunately, there's just something mechanically wrong.
And is it a conversation at all, Shane? Is it a situation where the doctor says, if you do this, you will have long-term implications in terms of your mobility in that leg? Or is it fairly clear-cut where it's like, you can't possibly get to the high-octane level of being an intercounty hurler again, given the current condition of the knee?
Yeah, so like, as he said to me, you know, afterwards that day, he came down and spoke to me, and he said, "Listen, your goal coming down here today was that you wanted to be able to leave here and walk properly. You wanted to be able to play a game of golf. You know, you wanted to be able to live life normally." And he said, "We've achieved that because," he said, "I've removed the loose bodies from your knee and I've cleaned out your knee." He said, "To be honest, I actually can't understand how you have gone on for so long with them loose bodies in your knee. If you're feeling them symptoms for the last couple of months," he said, "you're obviously there for the last couple of months." But I suppose I was so blinkered in terms that I thought the rehab was going to work, you know. So he just said, "Listen, he said, I currently have a hole in my knee. I have a hole in the cartilage. So I have two decisions. One, I leave it as it is and it won't affect me my day to day. It shouldn't affect my day to day. Or two, is I get another procedure where, as I said, it's crutches for 3 months and rehab for 9 months, or another 6 months, be 9 months in total. And then, but by the time that comes around, I could have another defect in my knee because the cartilage all around the side of it is all diseased as well."
Right. So talk us through the process then after the reality hits home, Shane, like about the last 2 weeks. Who's the first person that you tell? Because, like, I'd imagine initially it's hard to sink in that the intercounty career has now been taken away from you.
Yeah, listen, I know I was going to be under big pressure without coming to a decision. I suppose this is obviously a huge decision in my life. I wasn't going to just come home Wednesday evening and say it's all over and off I go. Like, you know, I obviously thought about it, spoke to people, and I did, and I spoke to different professionals, and I spoke to friends, and I spoke to myself. That was a big conversation to have with myself. You know, that's important as well. And I knew last week, and I said, "Listen, it was affecting me because, you know, I was lying to everybody, telling them that I was coming right." And then the club championship starting back up, people were asking, you know, would I be playing a part in that? And I knew I wasn't going to be, and it was affecting me. So I said, "Listen, the inevitable is the inevitable. So why delay it?" And so then last Friday evening, last Wednesday, I text John Kiley to me for a cup of tea, and he came into the house and we just sat down and had a chat. And while I knew what was going to happen or what I was going to say, he wasn't shocked. He had a fair idea what he was coming in for. And but I suppose when he left, you know, he's the boss man, he's the banished door, and that really put the nail in the coffin for me, obviously.
What did he say?
He said it doesn't sit well with him. It's very upsetting that a 27-year-old has to do this. I know John for a long time. I've worked with him for a long time. He was upset, without a shadow of a doubt. But what can you do?
When you say you're having conversations with yourself before that point, how do those conversations go?
They're tough. Because what you start doing then is you start thinking back of everything down to the years since you were a young kid, and you know, all the hurling that you've done and the lads that you've met and the memories that you've created, and that's quite sad, you know, thinking back of something that you love and it being taken away from you. They're very, very difficult.
Well, in relation to that self-talk that you were talking about, Shane, was it like, it sounds like there might have been a part of you that you were almost trying to convince yourself on some level that maybe it wasn't over?
Well, one thing I'd like to think I am in life is a realist. I don't like to think stuff that's not possible or anything like that, or say stuff that I know isn't going to be possible. I just literally said, right, look at the different options. What am I going to be able to do here? It didn't take that long. And I just said, listen, I was able to get the surgeon took pictures in my knee when the camera was in there. And I took them pictures away with me, and the four loose bodies, the four loose pieces of cartilage in a container, they were all in a package for me to bring home. So, like, as I was making the decision, I was just looking at them and saying, look, well, I have a big hole in my ear, first of all. So, I have to get an operation if I want to try play number two. And that operation, as I said, takes a long time, but the risk of it going again is extremely high.
Yeah, that's a pretty real thing to have in your hand, very tangible thing to have in your hand. What you mentioned a bit earlier on about the Schlock-Neil game, particularly the semi-final, and maybe you said that maybe you'd come back a bit too early. Have you any sense or regret about that sort of stuff, or a sense of the impact that that has possibly had in terms of rushing back or recovery?
No, definitely not. I don't. I wouldn't change it for the world, to be honest, because I got an All-Ireland club medal out of it that year. So
do you think it negatively impacted on your knee?
Sorry, I didn't get a club medal. That's the year we lost it. Sorry. No, it didn't. No, we didn't. We didn't. I don't think it made an impact. I don't. No, I think okay. my cartilage is diseased, and that's the bottom line. I don't think it would have made. If the hole was in the same area where he'd already repaired, I'd say possibly. But the where he is repaired in the last two occasions have come back perfectly fine.
Okay.
I remember, Shane, you speaking after 2018 about how overcome with emotion you were when you saw how happy your parents were after you won the All-Irelands. I'd imagine even beyond John Kiely, those sort of personal conversations have been another level of tough over the last couple of weeks. How has that been for you, speaking to your parents and telling them about that?
Spoke to John on Friday, and we said, listen, you know, I wanted to tell a number of people, and I didn't want to getting out before yesterday because I wanted to make sure that I was able to tell everybody that I wanted to speak to individually and everything that I wanted to give them the respect that they deserve. And so I had to say it to a number of different people, and obviously my parents being the most important. I called over to them Saturday with the intention of doing it. I didn't. I wasn't able to. The exact same happened on Sunday. And I said to myself on Monday, listen, I have to, like, you know, and what was happening then is I was telling a couple of other people, and I said, if they hear it through someone else, that's going to be a very, very poor reflection on me. So, you know, I had to stand up to it. They're my parents, and they've been the people who've led me in the direction that I'm in. And so, I met him on Monday, and I suppose the attitude I had was I was going to go in and say, listen, I'm going to pack it in. It's all over. I don't care. And sure, listen, we all plow on, and makes no difference. As in, I wanted to play it down completely, so the day kind of, and I literally went in, and even before I had a word spoke, I broke down. So I think I actually frightened them. I think they thought there was something seriously wrong, but anyway.
Yeah, and I presume that that's obviously tied up with the amazing moments that you've had in terms of the success and the level of achievement that you've had and the investment that they've had in you. Like, I can only imagine what it must be like to having been on that journey, because you mentioned it in your statement and you've mentioned it here this morning in terms of that journey that you were on. And I can only imagine the investment that they've had in you. I'm assuming that that's the difficult part of having that specific conversation.
Yeah, and listen, they've put up with a lot down through the years. Like, I'm a moody man when hurling doesn't go well or when I don't go well, and they've had to look at me and listen to me for long enough during the difficult times. I mean, obviously in the last couple of years things have been great. We've won a bit and it's been easy for everybody, but for them, you know, when I was obviously, you know, living at home up until 2 years ago, they had to put up with a lot, and that's why, listen, they're the most, them and your close friends and family and everything, they're your most important people, and that's why, because they see how you are during the difficult times when nobody else does. Yeah. So, but I suppose, listen, I want to ensure that this doesn't become about my knee injury. Yeah, it's very, very difficult, it's very sad, and I'm genuinely heartbroken. I'm not going to say otherwise, but I'm extremely lucky to have the career that I've had, to be playing with the people that I've played with, and to win what I've won. Because, like, you know, I'm literally just a guy that wanted to play hurling and to try reach, you know, something where nobody else got. And I'm so fortunate that I happened to do that.
Yeah, I'm sure your parents, like, they just want the best for you as well, right? Like, they actually don't really, when you come back and you deliver that news and everybody gets over the shock of it, they just want you to be happy and well.
They do. Listen, that's, and you've hit the nail on the head. It's that simple. You know, it's sad for them. It's sad for everybody. That goes without saying. But it's far from trouble. It's far from trouble. I spoke to, you know, different people over the last couple of days who have faced real trouble in their lives. And, you know, that really put into perspective for me. And listen, I'll be fine and they'll be fine. And as you said, once I'm okay, they'll be okay. And I'll certainly be okay. No doubt about that.
We've had a comment in here from Aaron who says, lads, please thank Shane from everyone in Limerick. What a legend he has been for us. So many great days in green. And as you say, I mean, not many people get their hands on an All-Ireland medal, and that's been achieved in terms of achieving everything you possibly could have. That's the big box ticked. And, like, you start to wonder then, and personally I wonder, like, what is next for you, Shane? Like, on the first level, what happens next in terms of your own health with that knee? Is there going to be a process of physiotherapy on that to ensure that it doesn't give you bother down the line, or how are things going to work?
Yeah, so what's next is even difficult to answer, because I suppose right now, as I said, I have a hole in my knee. So over time, that actually forms with fake cartilage. Very complicated. No need to go into it. But that will kind of form. That hole will fill over. But that will fill over if if you give it time and if you don't go pounding at it. You know what I mean? So, that's the first thing. And I suppose I should be able to go back jogging in a couple of weeks' time. And I know it sounds quite dramatic that you're holding your knee and you want to go back jogging. Like, these holes are probably really, really small in the greater scheme of things, you know. But I hope to be able to go back jogging. And, I don't know, is a club campaign possible or not for me? I don't have the answers for that. I'd love to think it is. That really upsets me. I mean, the reality is everyone's going to come and go from Limerick. Everyone's time comes to finish with Limerick at some stage. Everyone knows that. But, as I said, I'm a 27-year-old lad that, you know, grew up beside the Piershig and is obsessed with the Piershig and the people that are there. And, I don't care what I've won with the Piershig, you know, or what people might think I've won, and that doesn't bother me. I just want to go down and play hurling and be competitive and do what I've always done in my life. And, I don't even know if that's possible. But, listen, we'll give it every chance. I'm not under any time pressure with my club. If it's not this year, so be it. It could be next year. Who knows?
Yeah. It just struck me, and we'll have you in at some point, Shane, and have a proper sort of debrief on the career. It's probably not really the day for it today, but it did strike me that I was just thinking about it last night. Joe Canning often talks about that sort of that monster score in his first senior game, the Galway, one of his first senior games for Galway anyway, and how it was used for a lifetime to hammer him because he wasn't scoring 212 every game. And you came into the senior setup with an unbelievable reputation, obviously, from underage. Did you find that you thrived off that, or did the pressure weigh on you, or how did you find you dealt with that reputation coming in?
Well, it didn't bother me because I came in and I didn't feel under any pressure because you get away with it for a couple of years. If you're 18 or 19 years of age, you come into a senior panel. If you don't play well, you're a young flesher. Given time, he'll develop. And if you do play well, it's a bonus. And at the time, I suppose, Limerick weren't where they were now, or where they are now. So I never thought, there were some fantastic people around me. Brian Gearing was still playing, Dodge was still playing. You know, there was, and then obviously there was a lot of others, but them being the two elder of who was there and who I would have looked up to playing growing up. And they were extremely good to me. And, I'd love to think that I was like that with the younger lads that came in recent years, but I never felt pressure going in there. I always enjoyed it, and I was surrounded by great people and great management and a great county board. And I just remember the memories that I had. And I suppose growing up, listen, the fact that we were winning Hearty Cups and the club was going well and all that. I always enjoyed it. I never felt the pressure of that, to be honest.
Yeah, I don't know that text from Aaron, if it was from your teammate or not, but when you look across the names that are on that team, Shane, Galan, Lynch, Kyle Hayes, is there, you yourself, a very young man, you know, in terms of the longevity of those careers, is there an element of that that's sort of impacting on your maybe emotion or your thought process around leaving that Limerick team, the excitement that's there for them now, you would think, over the coming years?
Yeah, no. To be honest, whether Limerick are going to be competitive or not going to be competitive remains to be seen. What I do know for a fact is that I extremely miss the group. The crack that we had, literally, I loved the dressing room. If training's on at 7, you might be there for whatever time, 6:15, and that half an hour in the dressing room beforehand was some laugh. You know, we had my own seat in the Gaelic Rounds in the corner and, you know, everything that was there, and that's what I miss. I'll go down, I'll miss the trainings because they're obviously of a very high level. You know, you miss coming home, feeling that you've achieved another great training session under your belt, and I'll just miss going down playing hurling. It's as simple as that. Whether Limerick are competitive or not, listen, that's one thing, but I'll just miss playing the game that I love.
Will you get a chance, Shane, to get down and sort of face-to-face in so much as it is at the minute to sort of say your few words to the group?
To be honest, they're probably going to meet in a couple of weeks' time just to maybe talk about plans going forward or whatever the case may be. And it was an option for me that I could have went in and spoke to the group. But knowing how I felt and knowing my emotions over the last 10 days, I felt that wouldn't be possible because I know that I'd have opened my mouth, or even before I opened my mouth, and that would have been it. I wouldn't have been able to speak to them. So I put a video into the WhatsApp yesterday rather than a text message. I can assure you it wasn't a one-take video. And that was as close as I was going to be able to get to speaking to them in person. But, you know, the majority of them, I've spoken to the majority of them since, and, you know, I've been absolutely humbled and honoured by the words that I've received from, obviously, the people that are close to me, but from across the country. I just can't believe what some people have said, and it really humbles me, and you know what, it makes me emotional, because I'm so grateful for what people have said. It really means a lot to me.
I saw a fraction of it online yesterday, Shane, in terms of the people that were getting in touch with you, and it was monster. I presume the phone's been hopping.
Yeah, it has, and I tell you, any person that has contacted me individually, I will be getting back to everybody, because I respect and I thank everybody that took the time out to send me a message, because it means a lot to me. And as I said, online, on social media, I'm on it. I'm not oblivious to it. I see it. And, you know, I suppose I've seen bad things down through the years too, like us all. I'm extremely humbled and honoured by, and some of the calibre of people that have contacted me as well. I can't understand why they have, but I greatly appreciate it, and it does mean a lot.
Well, Shane, congratulations on an incredible intra-county career. Very best of luck with what's next with that jog in a few weeks. Hopefully it happens, and hopefully the recovery goes well. Shane Dowling, thanks a million for taking the call.
No problem. Thanks, guys.